真一長談，再次翻嚟，我哋同Jack Austin 參議員為我哋講解一下，佢喺做參議員嘅時候，佢做咗係點樣做嘢，有啲咩規則，等我哋多了解一下一個參議員喺法定嘅同埋佢哋平時嘅運作裏邊度係點樣樣為我哋服務嘅。Just now you have mentioned on the first part about the money issue. I think it was $4,000 worth of real estate over, and then at that time, and then also that your asset and your debt, that ratio, you have to have at least 4,000 the surplus, and so. If you count today's money, in today's money, it's $175,000 at least. So, is this still practicing, or is just something conventionally put aside?
Well, you're absolutely right that I was explaining the property classes wanted to be protected against the popular voters. So a constitutional rule was that you had to have real estate worth at least $4,000 in 1867, right? And you had to have a net personal value of more than $4,000. It's never been changed, but as you point out, it doesn't much matter. Today, you still have to own real estate, and that's why Senator Duffy and Senator Wallin, who are now very famous senators, appointed by Mr. Harper, by Prime Minister Harper, owned little houses in Prince Edward Island and in Saskatchewan to qualify, because you do have to own real estate. So, constitutions are hard to change.
Yes.
And so once that was in the Constitution, it was never worth the
That's
fight.
why the Supreme Court has that opinion of the reform of the part. We will go back to the reform of the Senates, but before that, I just want to share with everyone is that in 1997, do you still remember that time when Sister Peggy Butts?
Butts was there, yes.
Yeah, Butts was there, and she was a Catholic nun. She
Correct.
has no money, and so the church has to put a certain
$4,000 worth of
4,000
property.
a property in her name. So
Yes.
for us, it's ridiculous. But particularly today, but a lot of time, as you said, constitution is difficult. And we'll talk about how we can get around all these things without having to consult all the or approval by all the provinces. So, yes, you have
Yes,
something.
well, no, I have to say that the federal government and the provinces in this country have separate jurisdiction. And in our constitution, you can't change the constitution unless you have the agreement on some issues of the federal parliament, meaning the House of Commons and the Senate. And seven provinces representing 51%, 50 plus 1% of the population. In other issues, you need all 10 provinces. So the federal government is not by itself the supreme power in the country. The supreme power is the federal government and the provinces.
Yeah, so that's why when the Supreme Court's opinion on the reform of
Constitution, Senate,
of the Senate, it has it is a constitutional issue, and that every province has to agree on it. So it seems that it's a deadlock, and there's nothing we can do. But for instance, time has changed, and we today we have 775,000 population, and we only have six other senators. And then the Nova Scotia has so much smaller, they have 10. So this kind of inequality, is there any way we can get around to make it right? Because it is not, in my opinion, is not doing very good for the patriotism in Western provinces.
Let me explain it this way. First, I agree with you that BC is underrepresented substantially in terms of population. But in 1867, the three provinces, Nova Scotia, Prince Edward Island, and New Brunswick, were independent colonies of Britain. And their terms of joining Canada and giving up their colonial status were that they would be represented by more senators than they could be represented by election of into the House of Commons because of their populations. Because let's take a standard, 125,000 people elect a member of parliament, just theoretically. Okay? Well, they saw Ontario and Quebec as big population provinces, and they said, we'll be swamped unless we counterbalance so that we have more power in the Senate than our population allows. At that time, the Western provinces had very few people.
Yes.
And in fact, they weren't provinces until Alberta, for example, and Saskatchewan until 1905, right? When they settled at that time, each of the four Western provinces got six senators when they became part of the Confederation, which was appropriate at that time. But of course, populations change. But when we came to change the Constitution in 1982,
yes,
that's the last major change of the Constitution, everything is a negotiation in Canada amongst people who have, it's like having a door that has 12 keys. And you have to have somebody, every one of them has to agree to turn the key in order to open the door.
At the same time.
That's the Constitution of Canada. Very different from China.
That is
extremely
a very,
different.
Very interesting analogy.
So the idea is that this country is a country that has to, the people have to negotiate all the time the trade-offs of interests. So in this province, Premier Christie Clark can say, oh, the federal government has the jurisdiction to build a pipeline to the coast, but not unless it solves five problems that I have. They are preconditions to BC cooperating.
Yeah, we have more, the province are more powerful than the states in the United States.
Yes, right, and far more powerful than the
provinces in China.
China. Far more powerful.
So what happened in 1982 if there was an opportunity to change the constitution? What happened?
With respect to distribution of senators?
Yes.
Well, the Quebec and the then four Atlantic provinces, now including Newfoundland, have said no. And Mr. Trudeau said, we have much more important things to agree on. You know, if you disagree on this, I'll give you that, but you have to give me this.
And you must have fought fiercely.
I did, and I introduced a constitutional change in the Senate to give BC 12 senators instead of six. And I was supported by one conservative senator, so it was nonpartisan. But unfortunately, the Atlantic senators and the Quebec senators wouldn't vote for it.
Particularly Nova Scotia and New Brunswick, they have such smaller their population, and they both have 10 senators. And so, okay, I do understand that the constitution is difficult to change, and so, but we have to grow, we have to evolve as a nation. So Justin Trudeau, your boss, Stan, he has the media said fired, but I don't like to use that word. He has neutralized the political alienation.
Freed them.
Do you think, as a senator with practical experience, do you think that will work?
There have always been two ideas about the Senate, right? The original idea in 1867 was that the senator would be like a judge. They would be appointed for life, they would be independent, and they would use their very best judgment and experience to get the best results for the country and for their province.
Mm-hmm.
And so the focus of the Senate has always been policy rather than politics.
Mm-hmm.
Originally, that was the concept. But the so-called fathers of Confederation of the time made a mistake, insisted on by the then Prime Minister, John A. Macdonald.
Yes.
He said, yes, you're absolutely right about everything, except I get to appoint the senators. And that destroyed the idea of independence. Because people then needed the prime minister to appoint them, and over time, the people who were chosen from the most partisan and agreeable senators
yes.
to the prime minister, yeah. correct? So the idea of a check and balance was modified. It wasn't destroyed, but it was modified.
Compromised
yeah.
a bit.
Yeah. yeah, and today, it's ultra political, the Senate.
Yes.
So Mr. Trudeau, Justin Trudeau, is saying, I believe in the original concept. I believe the senators should be picked from the best people in the country, and then they should be allowed to use their judgment to advise the country what's mm-hmm. in the best interest of the country and their province.
Yeah. I think the voters and you will decide which idea is better, but I do think that we need to be creative to solve this the constitutional really strongholding on a lot of reform that is really necessary and to the Senate's. Thank you very much, Senator Austin. Because now we get a little bit out in the indoor of the Senate Hall and to know what you do and how you practice your duty as a senator. 周一長談，我哋今日咧講嘅係參議員佢嘅工作，同埋一啲好我哋要改革所碰到嘅困難，同埋應該或者我哋點樣用比較創新嘅方式去處理呢個問題，等到更新我哋參議員能夠更反映到今日嘅社會同今日嘅民意。我哋呢個話題會繼續同大家傾嘅。我哋今日咧就到此為止。周一長談，我係黎柏佳BCD，下個禮拜再見。
如果各位觀眾對於周一長談或者呢一集嘅內容有任何嘅提議或者意見的話咧，歡迎大家將你嘅意見 email 到 info@longshan.com。多謝大家。